Hi, everybody. Today, I want to talk about habits. Habits you've had, habits you've given up, and habits you're creating. There are a lot of habits over the years that I've given up and have corrected. One was watching soap operas. I used to watch them when my kids were little, and, you know, it was something to do in the afternoons. And because I was a stay-at-home mom, and while they were at school, you know, I'd do my cleaning and all my errands and stuff in the morning. And then in the afternoons, I would just sit down and watch the soap operas. So I gave them up tons of years ago, and couldn't believe the free time I had after that. To be able to go out and stay out and not worry about rushing home to watch General Hospital or One Life to Live or whichever. Those were the two main ones I watched. But anyway, that, and then next came biting my cuticles. I used to bite my cuticles. I didn't really bite my nails so much, but my nails are really soft. But if you look at that, you see that ridge in my thumbnail? And I've got a little bit of one in here. Well, this is progress. They were smoother than this, but lately I've been pressing on them again. If you press on them right here, you know, when you're biting it, my nails are soft. And when you bite on them like that, it presses down and it just makes ridges. Well, my thumbnails used to be just ridge, just like a bumpy, bad road. They were horrible. And so I gave that up. I used to put Band-Aids on them so that I wouldn't bite them one at a time. You know, I'd work on one at a time. And I was successful finally, and I quit doing that. Although, in the winter, I still pick at the, you know, like the little hangnail things. And when your cuticles get dry, I tend to pick at them. But I don't bite them like I used to. Scooter, of course, wants to go outside. Scratching at the door. The other habit that I gave up was smoking. That was a huge one. I smoked from the time I was probably 17, maybe 16, until I don't know how old I was, but I stopped 9 years ago, 9.5 years ago. And I had tried many times over the years to quit for one reason or another, you know, pressure, my kids. Quit, Mommy, you're going to die, you're going to get lung cancer, and, you know, all that kind of stuff. I'd get all the complaints from everybody. My husband, he had quit, God, when the kids were little, he quit smoking, so it was so long ago. And I kept smoking, and I just couldn't give it up. I smoked for 37 years, and I was smoking, if not two packs, close to two packs a day. I mean, you know, granted, I was smoking the lights when they came out with those, but still, it was awful. The thing was, you know, I was never successful in quitting. I never lasted more than a week or two, and I was so grouchy, and, you know, my husband would beg me to start smoking again because I was such a grouch. And I couldn't sleep. I was having withdrawal, and it was horrible. And then finally, it got to the point where it became inconvenient to be a smoker. I avoided going places because I couldn't smoke. I didn't want to go visit friends who didn't smoke because I couldn't smoke there. I hated going to, not so much movies because you were conditioned that you couldn't smoke in the movies, but different restaurants that didn't allow smoking I didn't like to go to. You know, just different things. And I started to become aware of the smell, and I didn't want to smell, and I was always worried about my breath. My mouth was always dry, and I always had something to drink or some mints with me. It was terrible. So I decided, you know, that's it. I'm done. I don't want to smoke anymore. And so I had something on my lips. So I had a carton left, and I decided, okay, when this carton is gone, that's it. I'm going to quit. So I went to my doctor and I said, you know, I need help. I had a neighbor who tried hypnosis. She tried to patch. She tried everything. And the only thing that worked for her were these little inhalers that you They look like the tips that you might put on a cigar or something, but they're these little tips, and you just take a puff or two when you need it. It's on my mouth. Ah! Anyway, where was I? Those inhalers. And you needed a prescription to get them. So he said, okay. So he gave me the prescription. I got it filled. And so the day came. I was on the last pack of cigarettes, and I had, you know, like four or five left. And I don't know whether I was sad to see the last cigarette going and I was nervous about that, or I was just anxious to have it be done with and over with. And I never did realize which that was, but the last one I smoked and it was gone. And that night when I got on a computer, you know, I used a little puffy thing a few times and I thought, you know, I didn't really want it. And the next day, I didn't want it at all. I didn't want to smoke. I had no inclination. I had no cravings. I had nothing. I thought, this can't be this easy. So, you know, like a week went by, and still I wasn't using that inhaler, and I didn't want any cigarettes. I couldn't believe it. It was about the easiest thing I ever did. And I know you find that so hard to believe for those of you who do smoke or who have tried quitting. But what I decided is that, or what I realized is it's all in your head. You know, when you decide you don't want to smoke anymore and you're done with it, it'll be easy to quit. And that was the secret. And I had made up my mind. I didn't want to be a smoker anymore. And it didn't bother me. I mean, sure, it smells good when I have a son who smokes, and when he comes over, you know, and he goes outside and has a cigarette, it's like, you know, every once in a while I think about it, but it's a fleeting thought, and it goes right away. You know, I would never start smoking again. Oh, my gosh. But I do miss it at times. I do miss it. There are times when I'm really bored, and like I'm sitting on my computer, because apparently that's when I smoked the most, when I was on my computer. You know, because back in those days, you had to wait for everything. You click on a link and you wait and you wait and wait. Well, that's when I would light a cigarette or another one, you know, to pass the time while I'm waiting. And so during those times on my computer when I'm waiting for something, I think of cigarettes. a hard thought to get out of your head. But anyway, I'm glad I succeeded. Other habits. Let me see. There's a habit I have that I need to stop, and that is being a motor mouth. You know, I talk and talk and talk and talk, and sometimes people don't want to talk to me on the phone because I keep them on the phone too long. I have to stop that, and I have to listen more instead of talk, and I'm working on that, and I've been kind of successful with it. You know, I have since picked up a couple of people that like to talk on the phone, and I now understand what my friends went through when they couldn't get off the phone with me, because I had those thoughts, but it was like, how can you even think that? Because you're just the same. And so, anyway, so that's something that I continue to work on. Being outspoken and speaking my mind without thinking is another thing I'm working on. Losing weight. I have to lose weight. Oh my gosh, since I quit smoking, I've gained like 30 or 40 pounds. And I can't blame it all to not smoking, but I'm a snacker now, and I never used to snack. And but the worst thing is I snack late at night when I'm on the computer, because that apparently was my hardest time. And so I snack on things like those little Chex Mix things, you know, that you can get in 100 calorie packs. And peanuts, mixed nuts, like for digestive, they have digestive ones, heart healthy combinations, you know, and I'll get some of those and pour a little bit in a bowl, and not a bowl, but a little container, and I'll have them while I'm on the computer. And but I shouldn't be snacking like that. I'm sure that that's what it is, and I have to just eat less, because I'm tiny. I'm only 5'3", and I have small bones, and this weight is just killing me. It's killing me. I can't breathe, and I get out of breath fast, and, you know, for me, it's just not comfortable. So Anyway, the other thing, besides the habits and thinking about them, the other thing I've been doing, is, of course, is knitting. And I made these little booties. Look at that. Isn't it cute? I got this free pattern from my yarn shop. She said, if you buy this yarn, you get this free pattern. I said, well, I bought that yarn one time before. And she said, oh, well, let me just go get you a free pattern. So she got it for me, and I knitted it up. And I think it's so big. I mean, look how big it is. I mean, there's my hand, okay? Look, if I sit it on my hand, don't you think that looks too big for a baby's foot? Maybe a toddler, you know, but an infant? I don't know. So I didn't make the other one yet. But then I started making this little baby sock. And I found this yarn, and I thought, well, this yarn is nice and soft. It looks thin, but it's not thin enough. And I'm using these tiny little needles, like a size 1. And so it's knitting up really thick, and so it's not that stretchy. And so I'm going to trash that. The other thing I am working a little bit on the baby blanket. I did a few rows yesterday. It's going to still take a while. And I'm working on my sock. That color just does not show up on there. That it is not blue. It is like a teal color, like a green. I don't know why it shows up that color. I wonder. Well, see, that's green. It is not blue. Can you see the green now? There it is, green. And it looks blue when you take it away. Green. Not blue. Blue. I don't know, but it's green. A teal color. And so this is my sock that I'm working on. I'm doing the magic loop. And actually, I'm enjoying that. So I'm working. I think it's going to be too big, though. It's just really, really stretchy. And it's loose on my leg. So I don't know. I've been watching some videos. There's a website called Craftsy. Crafty.sy. And they have classes that you can subscribe to. And that they're not free, though. They cost, most of them are like $29.99, and it's a whole probably 5 or 6 hour course of how to make something, and with instructions, and they give you all the materials, they give you patterns, and you have access to it for lifetime. And you can go back and relook at the videos, and they're all videos. So I find that I can learn best through watching videos. And so anyway, I had gotten a couple on making socks, and I was watching that the other day over the weekend. And, you know, tips about different heels that I have not tried before. And so I might use some of that information. But they're having sales on them. Some of the classes now are just $10. Some are $19. You might want to check it out. There might be a class. They have all kinds, not just knitting and crocheting, but sewing, quilting, cooking, all kinds of stuff. So check it out and see if there's anything on there that you might like. Anyway, well, this is, what, 13 minutes? I'm not just a motor, see? Motor mouth. I didn't mean to talk this long. Well, yeah, that's what we always say. So I've got to go to the grocery store today. I was going to go see my dad, but I think I'm going to, since I have to go to the grocery store, and it's like 10 miles from here, and I got to go and come back and then go see my dad, or I could go on my way back, but usually that's late when I get back, and, you know, it runs into dinner time. So I'm going to blow it off for today, and I'll go see my dad tomorrow when I'll have more time to visit with him. But otherwise, he's doing great, and no problems there. So anyway, that's about it, and we had a good weekend. Our football team won. We're 2-0, and so that's great. And both of my – did LSU win? I think so. LSU and Alabama, I think, both won their games, the college football that we follow. That's about it. I changed my dog's food. I'm having problems with Casey. Oh, my gosh. I'll have to tell you all about that in another video because this one's way too long. I hope you all watch it. Okay. I'll talk to y'all soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.